Okay. Well, hello everyone and welcome back to One Shot. Oh my gosh! Who was this? I was doing my intro, sir. Unit RM2883417, reporting for duty. Where did you even come from? I saw that you spoke with the guardian of the settlement. I will now escort you until you reach your dormitory. What? Okay, this... Hello, everyone, and welcome back to One Shot. This is all happening so quickly. I just logged in, and I'm not entirely sure... am I supposed to follow you? He seems kind of sporadic. What? Are you following me? Am I following you? What is going on? Oh, I wonder if he's trying to, like, corral me into this place. What is this place? Looks like they're evacuating the few tamed robots we have here. Makes sense. No point in keeping them in the Barrens if all the people are already gone. I wonder if the engineer is going too. The engineer... What, is the engineer Silver? Apparently, phase one of the evacuation ended prematurely. The big ship started malfunctioning only after a few round trips. They said it was due to something with squares? I'm not sure what they mean by that. Bummer. Looks like they won't be able to transport most of these surplus bots to the city at this rate. And we worked so hard on those. Huh. But I suppose the robots are easy enough with transporting people as is. I think it's going to be our turn soon. What is- Oh, there's a ladder here. What are these? Is it just... How strange. Can I not go up top? I'm scared of ladders. Oh, we don't have to come up top. Why am I holding the glass bottle? I don't need to be holding this. Okay, so I have a sponge, strange journal, I've got things. Oh, there's another one of these. It's a power cell, I think. There's writing on this one too. It says Guardian of Residential Area. Oh, this is for lots of tiny shrimp. It's looking a little dim. Oh no, we have to get him a power. We have to get him a power source. Where did that one robot come from? Hi. By the way, some robots may start following you around the settlement as well. Do not be alarmed. It is their job to keep people safe. Oh. Okay, well that's nice of them. I just kind of want to explore around. I'm not entirely sure what I'm doing here or what I need to be doing. I guess I need to find one of the robots. I kind of forgot, but there was the one we found in the first episode. What is this? Another like little train cart. Oh, another robot. Hello. Checking, checking. Terminal does not respond. This is a problem. Oh no, some of the ink on this page is faded. Likely due to some sort of electrical or magnetic interference, I'm afraid this operation can no longer be sustained. If the servers continue to fail so much that maintenance cannot keep up the pace. Fortunately, it does not seem to be happening to the robots, at least not at a significant rate. Time will tell. Okay, there's so much writing and so much, like, for us to be finding out and everything, and it's all just, like, whoosh, like, coming at you at once. All of these terminals do not boot. I am not sure what to do now. Aw, these poor robots. I just wanted, oops, I meant to come back in here. We're back with the galaxy pulls, though, so I'm excited about that. Oh, hello. Are you, so you're just gonna follow me? Yes. Until you safely reach a building of your destination. All right. Oh. So are there things that'll come out and attack, like little Nico? This is so cute. We have like a little robot friend following us. I really want the giant robot to come out and help us or just kind of like start walking around with us. But I guess he's just the guardian. Okay, so let's come in here. These are, what are these? I remember being taught in school about the waters surrounding the forest, stretched until the boundaries of space. But at some point, the prehistoric oceans receded, forming what is now the Barrens. I wonder where all that water went. Huh. That is an interesting... I don't want to know... There's got to be, like, something in these. Right? And all that's over here... Nico's scared of ladders, so we won't make him go up. But... there's got to be something for us to find in these areas. I also feel like I need to put... some kind of gas or something in the bottle. Here's another note. A picture of a robot. You know, I've never been around so many robots before, Mare. And neither have I, Nico. Or any robots at all. I mean, I've seen them in cartoons and stuff, but I've never seen one in person. They're pretty neat, don't you think? Yeah. Hey, Nico, do a robot voice? Oh, I kind of want to see if he'll do it. What? Try talking like a robot. Ahem. Oh my gosh, this is adorable. Beep boop. Nico. I'm a robot and I eat batteries instead of normal people food. Oh my gosh, that is not correct. What? Oh. Robots do not consume batteries in the same way people consume food. In fact, robots do not possess digestive systems. Some robots do not even have mouths. Oh, I'm sorry. Mer? You made me look silly. Oh, I'm sorry, Nico, buddy. Oh my gosh, okay, so that's just a picture of a robot. So, there's this guy up here. Hello, hi. What are you doing up there? I am stationed here. By yourself? Yes. Oh. I'll be your friend. Do I say anything? Oh, nope. He's just talking about how he's stationed there. I wonder if I could give him anything. Well, it seems pretty lonely. Huh. I wonder if he knows anything. I should honestly be holding this. In case any of them know anything about the strange journal. I wonder if the guardian would know anything. He seems like he's been here for so long. He might know something. And our little robot friend might follow us. I'm fine with that. I feel like we do need to make our way back over to that robot. Oh, he stayed safe. He wished me to stay safe. Okay. All right, well, let's kind of come over here. Hi, do you know anything? Hi, boop. Okay, all right. Well, no one seems to know anything about this book, and I think we were just here. Yeah, this was... Okay, let's skip through this. Same conversation. Okay. So I guess we just need to try to... Ooh! What is this? Infirmary. Huh. I wonder how to use that. Oh, hello! Hello, organic person who is alive. The infirmary is up ahead. Oh, okay, these must just be signs. Look, it's a medical robot! Hello, person of organic makeup. Welcome to the infirmary. Scanning for injuries. Scan complete. Injuries detected? None. Treatment required? None. Okay, you're good to go. Thanks. So we just got an examination. Is there anything up here? Wow, this one's a tall one. Huh. Is there anything else? Oh! There is more stuff. It's a box of mechanical tools. Most of them are broken or rusted beyond use, but this plastic syringe seems okay. Okay! So I got a syringe. Needle. Okay, huh. I wonder what I could use that for. Hello, person. Are you seeking admission into the infirmary? No. Oh, carry on then. Huh, looks like I can't get in. Huh. Well, that's fun. I didn't know there would be an infirmary here, especially, like, when you think about it, all the people are gone. But I guess there's still... There were people here at one point, so they have to have, like, an infirmary. Huh. Looks like we're supposed to pack stuff for the evacuation starting today. I wish these books weren't so heavy. It's going to be a pain to carry them onto the ship. But they're by the author. I can't just throw them away. Huh. So it looks like we're seeing notes. Is this like where people... Oop. okay, pressing the wrong things. This is just like where people were living, maybe? Like these were where they were sleeping and stuff? I guess that would make sense. That's probably why there's all these papers. Hey, sweetie, 6 more weeks until you can come home. About time, huh? Gosh, I can't imagine living in that awful capsule wall dorm thing. Oh, yeah, so this is where people were living. But guess what? Soon you'll be able to sleep in a real bed and eat real food again. Right back soon. Love, Mom. Aw. I want to know, like, the story of the people and everything. I guess that's what we're going to find out, but... it's a very slow-going process, for sure. I really like these galaxy pools with the infirmary. Oh, reporting for... it seems you already have an assigned escort. Would you like me to leave? You can follow me if you want. I will now escort you until you reach the dormitory. Okay. Thank you. The robots are very sweet. Very silly, though. Evacuation? At such short notice? I can't believe this. First the sun dies, now I'm out of a job. Oh no. Goodness. It's a hard life. Some sort of mechanical drawing. Is there anything? Oh! A robot, it's beyond fear. Oh, that's so sad. So this, there has to be something. There's so many of these. There's so many people that used to be here. I guess they had to evacuate because of the sun being, like, it didn't really shatter, but it went out. Huh. Did I go in this one? I think I did. So was this just some kind of, like, town or something? Huh. It had to have been. I want to know what those books are. Okay, so we've been in that one, and I've been to the infirmary. And we have our little, you know, guards around us. Is there anything else? Okay. I guess that's just us passing through. Oh, this is the unbreathable air area. I wonder if there's any more places where I could possibly put stuff in the bottle? Hmm. I think we'll probably be making the way over to the... oh, hey! Yeah! This is one I think I could actually put... oh, I don't want to combine it. I guess you want me to fill the bottle with this gas, Mark? That ought to do it. Cool. So now I have a bottle of smoke. It's full of noxious fumes. Okay. So definitely won't be putting that or using that. Oh, there's a note over here. What is this? Initially, the amount of noxious fumes emitted by the natural gas vents caught our team off guard. Thank goodness the medical team reacted as quickly as they did. Despite its failure, the first expedition did bring up some interesting observations about the Barrens. We found out that there's not one, but two such vent zones. With fumes being pumped out at such high concentrations, it seems a miracle that the gas hasn't spread anywhere else. Our biologists concluded that the phosphor shrimp in the crater pools were actively consuming the gas. The shrimp in the ocean also prevent the gas from wafting up into the glen. Oh, we haven't been to the glen yet. If that's the case, then we owe a lot to these little guys. Oh my gosh, I keep pressing the wrong things. And I also keep forgetting about fast travel. Oh! Shrimp swamp. Where's the shrimp swamp at? Is that where I'm at now? Huh. Okay, maybe I'll try fast traveling there. I do want to talk to the robot. The robot, I mean. Let's come over here. I'm glad that I found that short one. I also feel like there, at some point there's going to be like some little secret or an item or something on one of these. Oh, wow. This is really like crowded. Okay, yeah, this is definitely where we were whenever we first came here. Because if we could just come back down here... yeah, okay, so now we're back where the robot was, and this was one of the original cargo holds that we went into. I think that has the bed in it. Is this the one with the bed? It is! I wonder if Nico will have another dream. I'm not sleeping anymore. Okay, Nico's not ready to sleep. That's fine. Okay, so let's come over here and talk to this rowboat. Robot. I keep calling him a robot. Or rowboat. Oh my god. Okay, hello. Oh, you're awake now. I am functional. You're so cute. Was it you who fixed the generator? Well, Mare helped me. I do what I can. But yeah. Hello, nice to meet you. I am Robot 310. Would you like me to take you somewhere? Are you okay? I cannot move. Oh no, well, you're still really rusty. That is true. Hold on, Mer and I will find a way to help you. Oh. Sponge? A sponge alone isn't going to remove all this rust, huh? Oh, I remember. Wasn't there... Some kind of... I remember the note, but I don't remember exactly what it said. Okay, well, let's kind of explore with the fast travel, because I want to see where the shrimp swamp is. Oh. This is the shrimp. Oh! Whoa! This pond sure looks different. The water looks like jelly? It's formed a bubble over the surface of the pond. How in the world did I get here? Also, what can I do with this? Huh. We're filling up the syringe? I guess it's kind of like a funnel. But the liquid might be a bit too thick to fit in the needle. Hey, it actually went in. Gross. Huh. What in the world am I supposed to do with this? I feel like I was reading, there's some note or something. I totally remember reading something and it was like, you have to be really careful, and that's why we need the rubber gloves. And we needed a sponge, we needed the smoke, we needed a few things to combine, shake up really well, and then be careful about it. I gotta find that book so I can remember how to do it, because I don't want to, like, endanger Nico. But here's a robot. The sky is dark. That it is. Do you know when the sun will be back up? We're working on it. Oh. Okay, I wanted to see if you said, like, anything else. We're definitely working on it. Nico and I, we're gonna be able to do it. Okay, I'm glad that I kind of just randomly came to this area. I just wanted to know where the shrimp swamp was. Wait, did I miss this somehow? Oh, I must have missed it, because this is right over by the robo area. Huh, okay, so let's see about traveling. Where's the lookout point? Oh, we're back with Silver. Hi, Silver. Nope, don't need further assistance. I do kind of want to play chess with you, though. That would be fun. I really forgot about the fast travel, and this is great. So, outpost. Oh, Prophet Bot! Galaxy! No, I don't have any questions. Thank you. Oh my gosh. Yay, we made it, and we're all the way back here. No, I don't think that the computer does anything anymore. It won't turn on, even though the generator's back on. Huh. Cool. Okay, so now let's go and travel. Oh, I'm inside, that's right. Okay, let's go back outside. And let's fast travel to the old factory. Oh, this is where I need to be. This is where I need to be. It seems like a page ripped out of a book. Cannot overstate the importance of cleaning solvents. This is how we get the rust off of him. Okay. Here's a simple recipe using the alternative method discussed in last chapter, utilizing natural properties of the phosphor. Okay, so acidic gas and blue phosphor, rare form. I guess that's what we have in the syringe. In a well-ventilated area, direct the gas into your container of choice. Seal immediately. Oh, wait, no, there had to have been more. Wasn't there more in this page? Without breaking the seal, inject the liquid phosphor into the container. Shake vigorously. Shake vigorously to initiate the reaction. Use as soon as possible. Okay. I know what to do. And I think we're gonna do it in the next episode. So we'll be cleaning off that robot. So I think I'll probably head over, fast travel there, and I will see you all in the next one. I hope you all enjoyed, and if you did, give it a big ol' thumbs up. All right, bye.